What's up, guys? It's time for Mavs News with Zane Trulock, Soraya Taylor, Emily Phillips, and Jace Spandex Sinks. And now, here is Zane Trulock.
Welcome to Mavs News. This week's blue ticket winners are, for kindergarten through second grade, Monique McCollum, Ashton Carell, and Lexi Bray. For third through fifth grade, Cannon Sherman, Mariah Camacho, Holton McClure, and Colton Kepley. This week's Mav Up Card winners are Madison Perkins and Brock Joseph. Pick up your prize in the office. And now, here's Soraya Taylor with the People of Norwood.
On this week's People of Norwood, we meet some more of this year's freshman class.
My name is Ariana, and I'm from Portland, Oregon. The one word that best describes me is energetic because I have a lot of energy. My greatest weakness is probably my friends. When we're in class and I'm sitting by someone I like, someone that stood up for me my whole life is my mom, because she's a very supportive person. What I like to do for fun is hang out with my friends. My dream job is to be an interior designer. Where I see myself in 5 years is in college studying interior designing. Something I would like other people to know about me is that I'm a twin.
My name is Jarrett Sinks and I'm from Norwood, Colorado. One word that best describes me is probably energetic, because I have a lot of energy. My greatest accomplishment in life is probably just playing baseball.
My greatest weakness is probably yoga pants. Something that makes me happy is probably baseball or my brother. The changes I'd like to see in the world is Austin Overholt to be my brother. My dream job is probably being a baseball player or being a coach. I see myself in 5 years probably going to college. I'll be going to college probably for sports medicine or sports.
Now here's Emily Phillips with a special report about school safety.
This week on Mavs News, we continue our series on the Standard Response Protocol, or SRP. The SRP establishes a common language in response to emergency situations that is used by the school, law enforcement, fire department, and emergency medical services personnel. This week we cover lockout. A lockout is called when there is a threat outside of the school buildings. This may be on or off campus. A lockout is intended to keep the threat outside while students and staff continue their business safely secured inside. When we go into lockout, you will hear the following announcement. Lockout, get inside, lock outside doors. During a lockout, students are to return inside their building and continue business as usual. Teachers are to bring everyone inside, lock outside doors, increase situational awareness, take attendance, and continue business as usual. Contact the office if you see any suspicious activities outside your building. School safety is a very serious topic, and we need everyone's cooperation to make Norwood schools as safe as possible.
Last week was homecoming. Here's a highlight of some of the activities.
Thank you. Who are you going to call?
Here are this week's activities. Tuesday, juniors will do SAT reading prep, first hour in the Math Corral. A representative from Fort Lewis College Admissions will be here at 3 p.m. for all interested juniors and seniors. There is a school board meeting in the Math Corral at 7 p.m. Wednesday, juniors will take the ASVAB test in the Math Corral at 8 a.m. UMC will be giving flu shots to interested students and staff in the Math Corral from noon to 3:30. The staff RTI meeting will be in the Math Corral at 3:50. Thursday, two college reps are coming to meet with juniors and interested seniors. At 1 p.m., Adams State will be here, and at 3 p.m., Western State will be here. Friday, there is no school for students and staff. And now, here's Jay Sinks with a sport report.
Sports!
Monday, JV football travels to Colburn to take on Plateau Valley at 4 p.m. Tuesday, high school volleyball hosts Ridgeway, and on Thursday, they host Uray. Game starts at 4 p.m. On Saturday, they travel to Ignacio for an 11 o'clock game. High school football travels to Sangre de Cristo on Saturday for a 1 p.m. game. And that's the sport report.
Here's this week's lunch menu. Monday, potato cheese soup. Tuesday, handmade pizza. Wednesday, burrito bar. Thursday, chicken pot pie. With every meal, there's always salad bar, fruit, and milk. And that's the news for the week of October 15th. Thanks for watching. See you next week.